Welcome back to this mini course on building vision applications with OpenVINO. In the previous video, we've seen the Python code for creating a full face detection application. As a recap, let's do the lab, Jupyter Notebook 4, together. If you're missing any detail, please watch the previous videos. First thing to do is to import all the required libraries. Second, we read the model. The model is located under the models directory. We load the XML file, but there is always a .bin file with the same name to hold the weights. Compile the model to run on CPU. If you'd like to run on a GPU, just change the CPU to GPU, that's all. And we're taking from the model the dimension of the input and the output layers. If you'd like to see that yourself, just print it like this. And the input layer is 1x3 by these dimensions, and the format is FP32. Let's load an image. I'll take a more interesting image with three faces. You can find the images under the data directory or bring your own image. We're taking the height and widths, resizing the image, rearranging the channels, and presenting it. This is the image. Now let's look for faces. So I'm setting the threshold to 0.1. You can play with the number. I'm using the compiled model, basically performing inference and getting the results into boxes. And here are the boxes with confidence level higher than the threshold. You can see that I have three boxes, so three faces were detected. And now let's see the result. We're setting the color. We're going over each of the boxes and drawing a rectangle, or basically drawing a box and showing the image. And we got three faces. Nice. Now let's add some emotions. So we are already detecting faces in the image. Let's try to estimate the emotion of these faces. If this could be done well, the implications are great, because now we can not only detect faces in the bus or the train station, but also know if they are happy or angry. Lucky for us, there is a ready model in the Open Model Zoo. If you navigate to the Open Model Zoo GitHub page, look for models, an Intel model, emotion recognition. You can find here the validation set used, all the specification, the accuracy, which is not high. This is not an easy task, even for us humans. And this is how to use a model. We need an input RGB image, 64x64. And the output is a vector of 5, which we need to softmax to find the dominant emotion. So our face detection model got an input RGB image with specific sizes. And we got a vector of 7 for each of the boxes, for each of the faces detected. This is video number 4 in the series. Please look for previous videos for the full explanations. The sizes of the boxes of the faces depends on the face size. But if we want to use the emotion recognition model, we need to resize all the faces to the required input size, which is 64x64. So in order to concatenate the models, we need to resize, reshape the faces images, the boxes coming out of the first model, to fit into the input of the second model. And after the second model was used, we'll need to process the output vector to determine the dominant emotion. And this is your task, should you choose to accept it, of course. But before I send you to do it, let me go over the steps you'll need to follow. First step is to get the models. You've seen that in video number 3. Use the Open Model Zoo downloader with the names for each of the models. Second, OpenVINO object and compile each of the models. Read an image or one image of a video sequence, adjust the size and format to fit into the face detection model. Execute inference, get the boxes, the faces out, resize, reformat each of the boxes to fit into the emotion model. Use the emotion recognition model in the same manner you use the face detection model. Extract the right emotion to display and display it on the original image. Basically, you have all the tools to go and code this small project right now. What you can do is go to Jupyter Notebook of Lab 4 and just add the code for the emotion detection on top. I'll give you a quick example. Here, I'm taking the model, I read it, compile it, and extract the input-output sizes. Since I have two models now, let's call this one face. So everything is underscore face. And now let's copy the same code to handle the emotion recognition model. I'll just change all the underscore face to underscore EMO for emotion. And the only thing left is to read the emotion model. You can find it under models. And that's all. Try it out yourself or watch me explain the full solution in the next video. See you there.